software project management. The topic is managing contracts and contract management. Managing contracts, types of contracts, acquiring software from external supplier. It could be done via a spoke system created specifically for the customer, off the shelf bought assets, customized off the shelf. ISO 12207, acquisition and supply process. So the figure represents the acquisition and supply process. Part of the ISO 12207 standard relates to the process by which software can be acquired from an external supplier. As can be seen from the diagram, there are two parallel and complementary processes. The acquirer has a set of processes to carry out which interact with the processes for which the supplier would be responsible. Types of contract: fixed price contracts, time and materials contracts. Fixed price per delivered unit contracts know the difference between goods and services. Often license to use software is broader rather than the software itself. Fixed price contract. In this system, a price is fixed when the contract is signed. The customer knows that if there is no changes in contract terms, this is the price they pay on completion. Even though the supplier will have to add their margin to the price to deal with contingencies. Advantages to the customer: known expenditure, supplier motivated to be cost effective. Disadvantages: supplier will increase price to meet contingencies. Difficult to modify requirements, upward pressure on the cost of changes. Threat to system quality. Time and material contracts: the customer is charged at the fixed rate per unit of effort, for example per hour. Because supplier appears to be given a blank check, this approach does not normally find favor with customers. However, the employment of contract developers may involve this type of contract. Advantages to customers: easy to change requirements, lack of price pressure can assist product quality. Disadvantages: customer liability. The customer absorbs all the risk associated with poorly defined or changing requirements. Lack of incentive for supplier to be cost effective. Fixed price per delivered unit contracts. Fixed price per delivered unit contract is often associated with function points counting. The size of the system to be delivered is calculated or estimated at the outset of the project. The size could be estimated in lines of COD, but FPs can be more easily derived from requirements documents. The price per unit is also quoted. The final price is the unit price multiplied by the number of units. These are now several years old. The bigger project, the higher cost per function points. Advantages for customer: customer understanding of how price is calculated, comparatively between different price schedules. Emerging functionality can be accounted for, supplier incentive to be cost effective. Disadvantages: difficulties with software size measurement may need independent FP counter. Changing stages in contract placement: the tendering process, open tendering. Any supplier can bid in response to invitation to tender. All tenders must be evaluated in same way. Government bodies may have to do this by local international law. Restricted tendering process: bids only from those specifically invited. Negotiated procedure: negotiate with one supplier. Stages in contract placement requirement analysis. The first very step, very first step in software development process is requirement analysis. The requirements are gathered from users or customers by the user management team, and managers are and specified in requirement documentation. Main sections in a requirement document: introduction, description of existing system and current environment, future strategy or plans, system requirements, mandatory desirable features, deadlines, additional information required from bidders. Evaluation plan. How are proposals to be evaluated? Methods could include reading proposals, interviews, demonstrations, site visits, practical tests. Off-the-shelf software clearly has an advantage here, as there is actually product that can be evaluated in existence. Need to assess value for money for each desirable feature. Invitation to tender. Note that bidder is making an offer is responsible to ITT. Acceptance of offer creates a contract. Customer may need further information. Problem of different technical solutions of the same problem. ISO 12207 refers an ITT as a request for proposal or RFP. Thank you.